new field is full of holm and cork oaks. There's enough room for everyone. It's important to Armando that his pigs get enough exercise. When they run around, the fat is distributed evenly through their muscles. In spring, they prefer to eat fresh clover. But from the autumn onwards, the pigs should eat bellotas, acorns. That gives the ham its nutty flavour.
The acorns are still very small, but we can calculate how many animals they'll feed. The longer they eat nothing but acorns, the better the quality of the ham. This year, the quality will be very, very good.
One thing is troubling Armando, however, the cork oak crisis. He can't live off selling ham alone. Breeding pigs simply takes too long. That's why he regularly peels the cork bark from the trees and sells it. All the farmers of this area do that. But for some time now, it hasn't really been worthwhile anymore.
Fewer and fewer real corks are used for wine bottles. Many producers are switching to plastic because it's cheaper. But that's a problem, because the entire ecosystem depends on us using the acorns and the bark. The first pig farmers are giving up and are looking for work elsewhere.
Armando hasn't reached that point yet. He goes to the ham factory in town as often as he can. It's one of the oldest in the region. Armando wants to see how his ham is doing. He had 80 Pata Negra pigs slaughtered here around 3 months ago. These joints are ready, but Armando's hams still need a lot more time. They have to dry and ripen for up to 3 years before they get the factory's seal. Armando is walking through the factory's sacred halls together with agricultural vet Carmen Blanco. The ham spends the summer sweating out its fat in the secadero, the drying room. It already smells delicious. The secret to making ham is a cold room full of salt, but not any old salt.
It's sea salt. It contains no additives.
The Costa de la Luz has the best salt fields in the whole of Spain. The salt refines the ham's flavor and preserves it. Although it's a risk not to use any additives, it increases the quality. I think natural production is best.
Carmen brought Armando's ham here after the pigs were slaughtered. The joints spent a good week in the salt. Now they're hanging in another one of the factory's cold rooms. Armando checks whether the salt was absorbed well. He doesn't want to see any crusts or even mold.
The ham looks good, and I like the way they cut it here. After it's salted, the ham stays in this room for 40 to 60 days.
Usually for 3 months.
Only then will Armando's ham be moved to the secadero, the last stage in the production process. Armando sells his ham all over Europe, but he keeps a few joints for the family.
Muy bien. chicos, vamos a probar un poquito de jamón esta noche.
¿Puedo coger un trocito?
No, así no.
Daughter Natalia is allowed to have a go at carving the ham. Carving the ham is a ritual for them. Natalia is trying it for the first time today.
Tiene que dejar que entre.
Eso también está mal. ¿Qué está mal? ¿Quieres venirte tú aquí?
In the beginning, I must have been just as bad. It takes a lot of practice.
Served with the jamón de bellota is homemade goat's cheese and a glass of red wine. A typically Andalusian meal.